My granddaughter, who's 14 months old, has just learned a new game. And the game is she plays it with her wooden spoon. And the game is she has the spoon, and then she looks at you, and then she gives you the spoon. And then you take it from her, and she lets it go. And then she watches you, and then you give the spoon back. And she's very happy to get the spoon back, but she's also very happy to give it to you. And then she turns to the next person, and she gives them the spoon, and then she gets it back. And then you can play with her. And the play is, well, now you've started to embody the principle of reciprocity, right? We can trade. And it's a repeating game. It's not one trade. You don't end up with the spoon, and I don't end up with the spoon. We both have the spoon some of the time across time. And there's some utility in the exchange itself. Okay, so she's playing with that and thrilled about it. And no wonder, because it's a walloping, walloping discovery. And so then you take the spoon from her, and maybe you hold it a little longer than she expects, and that makes her a little nervous. But then you give it back, and then she's relieved, and that makes her happy. Or you cover the spoon with your hand, and then she's a bit confused about where it might be, and you show it to her, and you give it back, and she's happy about that. Or she reaches out to grab it, and you pull it away a little bit and move it back and forth, so she has to do a little more effort to get it. And as long as you don't push that, and it's a bit of a challenge to her, both physically in terms of coordination, but also psychologically in terms of delay of gratification, she also finds that gratifying. And the reason for that is that you're showing how robust and resilient the idea of reciprocity is across sequences of transformations. And it's just this little thing you do at the table. You think, well, that's nothing. It's like, no, it's something.